welcome to the C.R.A.M Academy show, where we are creating real-world applications to math. Today we have a host lineup. We're going to again meet Mr. Cardio. Hi, Mr. Cardio.
How you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Good to be back.
Lord, it's wet out there, and I don't know if I sound stuffy or not, but
Who doesn't right now? I tell you.
Slept one day, the whole day. Wow. Yeah. So we so glad to have you here again.
Good to be back.
And the other lineup, what we're going to do is talk about a little bit of testing strategies. We want to talk to the parents. Parents, it's not too early to start getting in testing mode. I hate to be the barrier of bad news.
No, life is a test, man.
Yes, we need to get started. So it is January. The testing, she'll start like maybe the end of maybe the beginning of April, so it's not too early to get started.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
So we're looking forward to maybe giving our parents a few strategies of what they can do to get started for us, our testing. I just want to give you, you know how in school we have all these, what you call, alphabet educational soup?
Yes.
So are you familiar with C.R.A.M?
Well,
we're going to tell the audience about C.C.R.P.I. Okay. It's like, repeat after me like a teacher. C.C.R.P.I.
P.I. Uh-huh. Wow.
Yeah. Okay. So we'll talk about that.
I passed.
And here's another one. E.S.S.A.
E.S.S.A.
Have you heard that one yet?
No.
So we'll talk about
today.
Okay. We'll talk about ESA too. I mean, really, it's something that we need to keep up with.
Right.
A lot of times that our parents are just... Everything's just fuzzy, you know. Mm-hmm. There's people talking over here, teachers saying this, school district saying that, and with all this C.C.R.P.I., E.S.S.A., you remember it was the N.C.L.B., you know, so it's like, hold up, wait a minute.
That's a lot.
Can somebody just bring this to light for me? So we're going to do that today.
Good.
I think we can go on and get started. I want to talk to you a little bit about, what was that, kids fitology? Now, hold up.
Okay.
I see the word kid.
Right.
I see the Z, fitology. Ology is the study of, right?
Right.
So, and I see the word fit.
Yes.
And I see the word kid. So I'm going to say that kids fitology is the study of
kids
fitness.
Yeah,
got it.
Exactly.
Okay, good deal.
You pass. And by the way, since you broke it down like that, and that's what we want to introduce to parents and teachers and educators, is that we have to break these smaller words down. Mm-hmm. If a child understands what kids fit,
ology is,
their reading comprehension is there.
Wow.
And we did that deliberately because we wanted to show you how our program is somewhat working differently, because it's all about retention now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they can pass the test, but are they going to retain that information when going to the next grade level? And that's what we're, that's why you and I, C.R.A.M Academy and Mr. Cardio Tone Enterprises, are working together so our kids not only just read it and pass it, but retain the information.
Right. And I've been hearing, and you know, in the universe, you know, we're saying health before wealth.
Yes.
So
yes.
Even with the kids, you know, they need to be healthy.
Yes.
Before they can even go on to the next level
Absolutely.
In life. So
Absolutely.
I'm with you with
kids fitology.
So I'm seeing as I was reading, you're really concerned about obesity with the kids.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, everybody's screaming out, the kids are too fat. The kids need.
Yeah.
It's not the kids' fault.
No.
And here's why I say that. As I'm writing my program, the kids, my own children, three, four-year-old, years old, come to me. It's like, Daddy, can we? And first thing I tell them is get out of my face and write a program, go watch TV.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Me as a personal trainer, fitness. So even I had to come out of that mold.
Wow. Yeah.
But now what I realized was that it's not a problem getting children away from the television. We tell stories on the children. We tell it on.
Right.
Now, what I do is I take the television outside.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And what did I mean by that? I take the fun outside.
Okay.
Children want to be children. Children want to have fun. Children want to play. But we don't take the time out to interact with the children outside. That's where the problem lies. It's okay. Not them. So we'll be discussing that a little bit more, and that's what Kids Fit Solid is all about.
Ms. Cardio, I was just so moved Christmas Day.
Wow.
It blew me away.
Wow.
I'm in the neighborhood with almost 250 homes. There was not a child
Get out of here.
There was not even a child skating. There was not a child riding a bike. There was not a child. It was just, it blew me away. And I'm like, OMG.
You just hear so much noise and kids riding, screaming, playing.
Wow. On Christmas Day. 250 homes.
Oh, you
and
know
there
what?
There was not one child even pedaling the bike. So I'm with you with the obesity. Mm-hmm. We even us as adults, we have to move.
Yes,
you know,
absolutely.
Obama brought that into awareness.
Yes.
Move.
Yes.
Nothing else, just move.
That's all.
And the heart attack rate and the high blood pressure.
Absolutely.
All of those things are coming because we are not moving enough.
Absolutely.
So.
It's funny you mentioned that. I was reading some about the children in Vietnam.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Vietnam now. They're suffering from a case of obesity because they're bringing in the fast foods in these third world countries as well. So the places that we would never see this epidemic,
now we're seeing it. Right.
But as you said that, if you told me there was no kids, I see it as an opportunity. And that's the difference with what I do with Kids Physiology.
Yes, yes.
Okay, if there's no children out playing, okay, so how do we take an activity, even during Christmas Day, I do them even during birthday parties.
Mm-hmm.
How do we get the kids out of moving? And that's what my whole premise is with Kids Physiology. How do we find a way to get them outside? And I have no problem with it. And we'll be discussing that at some of our workshops because everybody wants to know and everybody always asks the basic question, who, what, why, when, where.
Mm-hmm.
But we're going to show you how we're going to do that.
I'm excited. Yes, I'm excited because I have two little ones. They're only two, and I can see if we keep the pattern. They're on the cell phone playing the games, and we're going to have to send them out in the backyard so they can move around. So I'm with this Kids Fitology. I learned that you had some interactive Kids Fit games.
Yeah.
What do you mean interactive? Tell us about one.
You know, one in particular, and I think when I met you at We Buy Black,
mm-hmm.
I was demonstrating one of them.
It's
called, this one here is called Musical Mats.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And what that is, in the daycare centers, if you notice, they have these mats with the alphabets, the shapes on it.
Right.
So I was like, why do you have them on the wall? Take them off the wall and throw them on the floor.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So once you throw them on the floor, I play the game as if we're doing musical chairs.
Right, right.
But what I notice is that the children are running, they're playing, they're moving, right? But when the music stops, just like musical chairs, the children have to run and step on that mat.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So on that mat, you have either your alphabets, your numbers, your colors and your shapes, and your basic geometrical shapes. So once the child runs and steps on the mat, he or she has to tell me what color, what alphabet, what shape, a geometrical, or what number that they're standing on. So as the kids are moving, they're actually learning.
Uh-huh.
So that's one in particular. But right now I have about 32 different activities, learning moving activities that the children do.
Okay. So do you go to schools? Do you go to private schools only? Do you do public school?
Anywhere.
Okay.
I like the homeschool concept and charter schools because they're a little bit more open to different types of education.
Mm-hmm.
Other than that, I run into too much red tape sometimes, and I think the program is so valuable, I don't necessarily have the time to fight against all that red tape because it's impertinent that our children, we get these programs in the schools and get our children moving. Otherwise, you know, we're wasting time and children are dying and creating all these health issues because we're caught up in red tape. So even churches, I teach my Bible, I call my Bible fitness games with these same activities.
That's wonderful. You know, fast forward. We don't want to get to the end of our rainbow to give all of our retirement money to doctors and healthcare. And unfortunately, that's the direction we're moving into. We are actually coming to the end of retirement, you know, high blood pressure, going to the doctors, giving all of our retirement to keep us alive. And that wellness is big. And, I'm, you know, that I'm actually a part of a big wellness initiative, but
you have to tell me about that.
It's a, I definitely will.
Well, you know, also, I'm a personal trainer.
Yes, definitely.
As well. But the problem I encounter, when I do senior fitness, one thing I found out, if they never moved and was not active, they're not going to move when they get older.
Wow.
You can put your money on that. Even in the face of adversity or failing health, we can't get a move. So it's a matter of learning things early, and that's why I want to start at 3, 4, and 5 years old.
I'm ready.
For the form of
training.
So
ready.
I figure if we get moving in,
so
know,
I need
lifestyle.
To start moving more.
And we will.
Because I won't move more when I'm older.
Absolutely.
So I need to move. Okay, tell me a little bit about that 64 chess piece. Board, do you work with?
Last show, I threw up the alphabets. This week, I have the numbers.
Okay.
And part of that 64 piece are your basic 8 geometrical shapes. And what I do, I time each child. I put all these pegboards on the floor, and I spread out the numbers, alphabets, or geometrical shapes. And I clock them and time them how long it would take for them to put all the pieces in place.
Okay.
Now, you're saying, so what I'm finding out, the children are working both sides of their brains.
Okay.
The left side and right side are inactive. Because they're moving, we get the brain moving, we get the blood pumping, we get that which is in motion has a tendency to stay in motion. So I find that's the best way to teach a child. Once you get them moving at first, and get them moving and active, then you settle them down. Their minds are wide open for education. I learned that when I was in the Marines.
Wow.
You know, so.
And so if you are a parent or educator or a teacher, if you have and would like to call in to speak to Mr. Cardio, our number you can call in is 470-251-4343. I'm quite sure if you have any questions, or even if you want to, you can actually send us a text on the phone here. We'll be able to read it. But thank all of you who are actually watching tonight. We're so excited to have Mr. Cardio here. And we are definitely on board with your vision, on board with what you believe in. And I saw it on Christmas.
I
was blown away.
Wow.
So I just need to know, where were they, and perhaps what were they doing?
Wow.
Because that's 250 homes in the neighborhood. And nobody was outside.
Wow.
Yeah, no one was outside, and that was kind of shocking to me. Yes. One last thing, tell us a little bit about the community outreach component.
The community outreach opponent is that, say for example, I was at my son's PTA meeting, parents' council meeting, and they were saying, okay, we need to raise money,
Okay.
So I was giving them some ideas. And what I realized is that people will give you money if they see the children. We want to be on television, here's the children. I said, no, you have to put your boots on the ground. You have to go out in the community where the people see the children, see the children with their stands up, doing the party packages. We're going to be doing lemonade stands because this is part of their community activism.
And so you're doing the community stands for selling lemonade?
Entrepreneurship. Yeah. Because there's no need to have a STEM program or any type of STEM program if we cannot teach our young people how they profit from the knowledge that they have. My STEM program is a STEM application program. It's just not, we're going to learn some cute facts, we're going to build. No. Because eventually someone is going to take that brilliant child of ours, send him to college, and I have a cousin that they did. he invented a mentor, a mm-hmm. computer mentor program for a major university, and guess how much he gets paid for it?
Nothing.
Thank you. Mm. So our children are brilliant. I had to figure out a way, how can our children benefit from the knowledge base that they have? And not saying that is a bad thing, but what I'm saying that is that our children need an alternative. So during our workshops, I would have some street, I call it STEM on the street. So mm-hmm. we'd have mm-hmm. some young men that would be doing a presentation and talking about how they're computer savvy, but they're not geared to go to college for 4 years. But they're making a lot of impact and a lot of money based mm-hmm. on their computer savviness and the media, social media, but they're doing well. Because all of our kids, and let's be honest, are not going to a 4-year college.
Yeah, and there is a shift going on. Yeah. I don't think everybody is understanding the shift that's taking place. And my sister and I, we talk about that all the time. The shift is that it may not be the education that's going to make the children wealthy anymore.
Right.
It's going to be their God-given talent.
Absolutely.
And they're going to have to know Absolutely. How to... take that talent and exalt it, let people know what they do.
Sure.
And unfortunately, our, who we are is baby boomers and millennium. The next generation, we're going to have to start talking that entrepreneurship.
Sure. Sure.
How do I actually invest in my talents and my skills mm-hmm. and not so much telling or taking the instruction from anybody, because that's really not what's happening in the future.
Well, you know what? Sometimes, really, honestly, let's be honest with one another. A lot of our children get a bad rap because of those few, mm-hmm. and we have a tendency to buy into that. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Oh, these kids aren't up. How much time have we spent with these kids to? Mm-hmm. And I have a good friend of mine working in Columbus mm-hmm. that knows you.
Yeah.
She said, guess what the questions in the high school is asked? Well, why don't we have any mentors? We want to know more about what the generation before us did. Mm-hmm. We assume that these children do not want to know. Mm-hmm. It's not that they do not want to know. It's mm-hmm. just they confused. When you're hearing something different on the radio, something different on television,
right.
something different on social media, their mom and dad might say that one particular thing once. Of course, they're going to be a little confused, but in their mind of minds and hearts of hearts, they want to know. So that's why I say this program, I have to make these ideas and these concepts accessible to them.
Okay.
Then they believe. So.
Okay. Today is Saturday.
Yes.
Just got to take some. Okay. So this is really good. Good information. Do you have a contact number?
I do.
Tell the audience out in on the C.R.A.M Academy show how we can even get in touch with you. I would love for you to meet some of these principals that could benefit from this.
Yes.
Yes.
Well, the best way to contact me, hey, look, I'm 52. I'm old school, so call me. Okay, y'all can relate to me. You can reach me at 706-300-6756. Once again, 706-300-6756. And by the way, we will be doing, working with C.R.A.M Academy and some other presenters.
Oh, yeah.
We'll be doing some workshops and seminars here in the Atlanta area, mm-hmm. in the Columbus area, starting off. I'm looking at the beginning of March, maybe the end of February. So please, if you're interested, the STEM program starts at age 3 to 5. Then we move them up to a STEAM program, ages 6 to 9. Then we move into a STREAM program that involves revenue and teach our children how money works, because money is a system.
Yes.
And a science. So show you how the money can revolve from point A around back to point A from mm-hmm. Beginning to end. So
wow.
So that's what some of the things we'll be discussing. Like I said, I'm interested in solutions. I'm interested in teaching how.
Mm-hmm.
That's what
mm-hmm.
we're gonna do.
And that's what that's exactly what the education arena wants the kids to know how.
Sure.
How.
Sure.
So we thank you again for being on the C.R.A.M Academy show. We'll see you probably next on the
next 2 weeks.
Next 2 weeks, yes. And you can just share again. We'd like to have everyone come out. We're actually showing on the first and third Saturday,
yes,
from 5 to 6. So remember I asked you about those alphabet,
yes,
pieces,
yes,
ESA and CCRPI. Mm. Which one would you want to know about first?
Which one has the fewest letters?
ESA?
That's a trick question. I'll tell you why.
Okay, so ESA is ESSA. Uh-huh. And I want the audience to know that ESA, SE, if you hear it, it's just there is an update. It's called Every Student Succeed At.
Ah, nice.
It replaced No Child Left Behind.
Okay, okay.
Okay, and when Obama was in office, he signed an act.
Yes.
Back in 2015. Mm. And so that's why you don't hear No Child Left Behind anymore.
Wow.
It's Every Student Succeed At.
Good.
Yes.
Beautiful.
And so it has this little twerks and perks, mm, and mm-hmm, of course, you know, they're always changing.
Sure.
But yet in the same, all of these different names, we're all trying to get to the same goal.
Sure.
And
absolutely,
that is to educate the student.
That's
and,
right. Yeah. That's right. Okay. That's right. Wonderful. So, wow. Give me the next one. I'm excited. Now I know what that means.
Yeah, SE or ESA, and it is a federal,
uh-huh,
and it comes down to the state, and
wow,
state,
wow,
wow, dishes it down to the districts.
Wow, wonderful, wonderful.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Okay, so the next alphabet test is C, like repeat after me again,
C-C-R-P-I.
Okay.
Just say it a little bit slower for me. I'm ADHD.
Okay.
Y'all feel me on that.
C-C-R-P-I.
C-C-R-P-I. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Gotcha.
So that stands for College and Career Readiness Performance Index.
Wow.
Okay, you might say, well, what is that?
What is that?
What it is that each school and each district is going to be given a number,
uh-huh,
that's going to tell how well they did, and the
sure
number is going to be from 1 to 100. And from what I understand, this year, 2018, this testing round can't be compared to any other years.
Okay.
In other words, according to the research, it won't be right to say, oh, the school increased.
Right.
Or the school decreased, because they are not comparing it to no other year.
Okay.
Okay. So this year, when they test, they can compare this year to 2018.
Okay. Okay.
Does that make sense?
It makes sense.
And then they can start saying up or down.
Okay. Gotcha.
But it's College and Career Readiness Performance Index, and each school has a number that has, based on how well the students did or did not do,
mm-hmm,
they're assigned an index number.
Okay.
And our parents, if you want to know more about that, you could actually go to Georgia Department of Education,
mm,
and actually, it's right there on the front page. It actually says, okay, view our 2018 CCRPI reports here, and it starts from all of the school districts,
mm-hmm,
and from the school district, you click on the school name,
okay,
and you'll see the number. So if our parents want to know how well, or actually don't have any way to compare it, but from a number from 0 to 100,
sure,
70 is passing, and your 80s are even better.
Mm-hmm.
And if we're below 60, we probably need some
support. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah.
Great deal.
And they call, you know, of course, we have to have some type of accountability system, platform, if we're going to be, you know, giving everybody a score. So,
mm-hmm,
of course, we had,
mm-hmm,
to look at that. And it's for our stakeholders, our parents, our stakeholders,
mm-hmm,
who are our stakeholders, our community leaders are looking, parents are looking, business owners.
Sure.
So we need to have that index to just get a feel of how well we're doing and what we need to improve.
Sure, sure.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I'm just getting into the education platform or okay. on the platform. Mm-hmm. So I don't know these things. So so I'm quite sure if I don't know them, a lot of parents and a lot of people out there
right.
have no idea. So it's good. I'm glad you're bringing that information forth. And it's just good. So I hope everybody's tuning in and taking this information. And because I'm interested in how that works.
Yes.
I'm all about solution oriented. So I'm right. a little nosy in this case.
And that would be good for you, you know, like, just like you said, if you see a school that is not doing as well,
I
they may just
absolutely.
Contract you and get you that. In. And that would be good. Listen, audience, again, thank you so much for actually tuning in to the C.R.A.M Academy show. If you would like to call in, our number is 470-251-4343. And I wanted to actually share with you, we have been volunteering at a school. Mm. And we've actually had some, the MAP scores, I don't know if you call them MAP scores, it's just scores that just get the pulse of the field, mm. how well they're doing, how well they're not doing. Mm-hmm. So C.R.A.M was able to volunteer and share the strategies, and
good.
From what I've heard, they've been doing well.
Great.
They've been doing well. Kids have been really, you know, embracing the strategies, sure. and that's what children want to do.
Absolutely.
Children, if you really want to get scores increased, we got to get kids to a win.
Absolutely.
And a win could be something just mm-hmm. simple as
simple.
Five problems right.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now I got my confidence built.
That's what self-esteem is based off of. It's the number of times I win.
The number of times I win.
And opposed to the number of times I lose. That's just simple things. But you're right. And one thing about you, Valencia, one thing is that the children know that you have the caring
yeah.
factor.
I do.
You have the caring factor. So the children want to engage in you because they can feel you. You know, like they
yes.
say, you keep it 100.
Right.
And children, you can't fool them. You can't fool them. Right. You can't fool them.
I'm going to show you when it's pulled up. I'll just show you some snippets of
sure.
of C.R.A.M. and you'll see
yes.
the kids, how they're engaged.
Absolutely.
And they are, you know, They're actually just involved in hands-on activities.
Good, good.
So when that
good.
Comes up, we'll be able to show and we'll continue to talk until it
wonderful,
does.
Wonderful.
Oh, there's one. I want to show you if it comes up. You'll see the students that are actually
that's
doing hands-on. But anyway.
Now what is that? Magisto? Magisto?
Yes. Uh-huh. Magista.
Magista.
Yeah.
Magista. Okay.
Okay, that's professional development with the teachers,
sure.
and there are some workshops that we did.
Good.
This is one
girl
actually on TV.
Good.
Mm-hmm. And that was just an interview.
If you have an event
shows.
Going on around town that you want us to know about, just send us an email.
Workshop.
Wonderful.
And we'll show you. And that's some teachers we're working with. Parent workshops are, and these are students who are actually verbalizing what they're learning. Yeah, verbalizing what they're learning. And this is what I want to show you. They're just excited. Yeah, very, very, very excited about learning.
Using their motor skills and everything.
Yes, absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah, and that's. And so,
that
was just
a little
snippet.
Yeah,
and then you see the kids with the actual, that was volume that they were working on.
Right.
And a lot of times we have a lot of hands on so they can remember
good.
What.
Absolutely.
Cause it's not enough that they're actually learning. Okay, they can learn the. Formulas,
right?
But
absolutely.
When C.R.A.M gets in there, we're hands-on. We're
sure.
actually, what is volume? Volume. Remember, volume used to be length time, width time, height.
I'm learning.
Okay, so volume. If you want to find volume, you have three numbers. You have the length time, the width
right.
time, the height. You know,
right.
pretend you have a box. Well, with those little cubes that they had,
uh-huh.
they could actually put length, width, and height and fill it in.
Good.
And then
wonderful.
Break them apart, and that will
wow.
show you volume.
Wow.
Yes, yes, yes. So
beautiful.
We're really excited about that.
Beautiful.
Very, very
beautiful.
Excited about that. So I was telling you about the school of volunteering there. They've increased. And
how long have you been doing the C.R.A.M Academy? Has been going into the schools, because you know I come to Atlanta, but well, I'm not.
The vision was back in 2004. And then 2008, I left the job to pursue the vision.
Oh wow!
Yes,
wow.
Yes, and wow. And one of the things. I did not want to, I wanted to move up, but I didn't want to leave the babies.
Sure.
And so in my space of prayer, God showed me what that looks like. Okay, show me what that looks like, and that's what happened.
Cool.
So I was able to move up and didn't leave the babies.
Good.
Yes, wow. Yes. So C.R.A.M has been around for since 2004. This is like year 15. Our anniversary will be year 15. Yeah. So, you know, of course, success is not a straight line, of course, and I'm still learning. But, yeah, we've come a long way.
You've been around for a minute.
We've come a long way.
You've seen some of these younger kids, children actually grow up to be adults pretty much.
Oh, absolutely. Yes, definitely. We love to see that. Yeah, so we've had in our space of our tutoring, we have had a little boy since he's been in third grade. He's 9/11.
Wow.
But I'm about to let him go on to the next level, because that 11th grade math gives me. I wanted to show you one more YouTube video, and it'll come up shortly. But I'm just so excited for you being here. Huh?
He said you don't have to.
Okay, that's fine. That's fine.
It wasn't me. I'm just.
That's fine. Okay. Well, listen, time is up, and we are so excited again, Mr. Cardio, to have you come. And I know you're going to come back.
I will. I'll be here in 2 weeks.
And thank you, everyone, for really being a part of the C.R.A.M Academy show. And we will see you in 2 weeks.
I'll be here.
Bye.
Bye, guys. Call.